In this lecture, we look into the concept of factorials. Factorials are not only easy to understand, but at the same time, they're also very useful, especially when we are dealing with questions involving permutations and combinations. So let's begin by taking a look at their notation. This is the symbol that we use to denote factorials, the exclamation mark. So if we had to write 6 factorial, we would do it this way. 6 followed by an exclamation mark. In math, if you see a number followed by an exclamation mark, you should know it refers to the factorial of that number. This would represent 8 factorial, and this 12 factorial. Okay, that was easy. But we still don't know what factorial of a number means. So let's move to the definition part. The definition says, factorial of a natural number n is defined as the continued product of first n natural numbers. Now this definition tells us how to find the factorial of any natural number. Say we need to evaluate 6 factorial. 6 is a natural number and so is covered by the definition. The definition talks about the factorial of a natural number n. So n is the number of which we are evaluating the factorial. In our case, we are working on the factorial of 6. So n is equal to 6. Again, the definition says, the continued product of the first n natural numbers. So in our case, the continued product of the first 6 natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So 6 factorial is equal to 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which would be equal to 720. Now we could have just as well written it the other way. 6 factorial is equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6. And that would mean the same thing. But for now, let's just develop the habit of writing the numbers in the descending order. And in the lectures to follow, we'll see why. So in the light of what we just learned, 5 factorial is equal to 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 equals 120. 8 factorial is equal to 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 equals 40,320. In general, for any natural number n, n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2, and the numbers keep on decreasing until we reach 1. Alright, so far we have learned how to find the factorial of natural numbers. But what about the other numbers? Fractions, irrational numbers, etc. Well, the factorial function is defined only for whole numbers, that is natural numbers and zero. It is not defined for other numbers. We know how to find the factorial of any natural number, but what about zero factorial? That we have not yet looked into. Well, by definition, zero factorial is equal to 1. So next time when you see zero factorial, just know that it is equal to 1. Here are the factorials of first few whole numbers.